Hi folks, welcome back to Padma Priya's Cuisine. I'm making some eggless mayonnaise today. It's a very easy recipe with very few ingredients which have to be all whipped up together. I've also made two variants of it with mint and tomatoes. The ingredients we need are 1/2 cup of fresh cream and 1 garlic pod, 1/2 teaspoon of black pepper, 1 teaspoon of mustard powder and 1 teaspoon of olive oil. If available, you can also use 1 tablespoon of mustard sauce instead of the mustard powder. We also need 1/2 teaspoon of lemon juice. Now this is store-bought lemon juice, but you can also use fresh lemon juice. I'm using a hand blender to blend it all together without any lumps into a creamy paste, just like the store-bought mayonnaise. Blending of just about 2 minutes will give you the very creamy texture of the mayonnaise. A perfect creamy mayo is ready now. I'll be mixing the salt separately because adding salt and then blending it would cause the cream to get curdled. Mayonnaise is usually available in different flavors in the supermarkets, but I couldn't find any because of the lockdown and the kids suddenly demanded for a burger and I had to whip it up myself. Let's make two more varieties, tomato and mint mayo. I'm blending exactly the same ingredients with the same measurements, but this time in a mixy jar. The measurements are also clearly mentioned in the description below. Make sure that the cream is really cold, otherwise when you blend or whip it up, it will start changing into butter and you'll never get the creamy texture. For the mustard powder, I just dry toasted the mustard seeds for 1/2 minute and powdered them. Make 2 equal portions of the mayo. In one portion, add 1/2 teaspoon of Italian herbs and 1 teaspoon of tomato sauce and mix it all together well. The tomato flavored mayonnaise is ready now. In the other portion of the mayo, I am adding 1/2 teaspoon of chaat masala and 1 teaspoon of green mint coriander chutney. Again, give it all a good mix and your Subway style mint mayonnaise is ready. Now 3 variants of mayonnaise are ready and they taste also exactly like the store-bought ones. They stay good in the refrigerator for up to 5 days. It can be used just as a spread for burgers and sandwiches or also for stuffing inside the stuffed pizzas or garlic bread. That's the burger I prepared for my kids and they just loved it. If you find my recipes good, please like them and share them and also post your feedback in the comments. Please don't forget to subscribe to Padma Priya's Cuisine and also click on the bell icon so that you get intimated whenever I post a new video. Thank you very much for watching my video. Please stay connected and bye-bye.